Hello everybody, my name is Manik Madan and I'm currently on my USMLE journey and I probably should match into a residency by next year. So in this video we will explore the three different ways to become a doctor in America. And like the first question I get asked by people is, can I become a doctor in America without USMLE? And it is actually not possible to become a doctor in America without USMLE, because everybody who's practicing medicine like has to go through something called as residency. In India, what happens is, like, even if you do your MBBS, like your basic degree, which is of medicine, you can practice. But in America, that's not true. Like, you have to first, like, even in America, you have to do your MD degree, which is their equivalent of MBBS or any other medical degree, like MBBCH. You have to first do your MD, and then everybody has to write USMLE and then do their residency. And only then can you become a doctor. Without USMLE, nobody can like become a doctor in America. Everybody has to go through residency. There is nothing such as like working after an MD or an MBBS. Now again, remember, this MD is not the MD or PG in India. It's actually equivalent to MBBS for US medical students, right? So every pathway that I'm going to talk about, the first one is about like, you know, going through your national medical school. Let's say for India, like I'm from India, I've done my MBBS from India. So that's the first pathway. The second pathway is like you go to an international medical school such as in Russia, Armenia, China, any place, and then you can do USMLE and then become a doctor in America. The third pathway is actually a very special one, which is going to a US medical school and getting your MD degree, which is again equivalent to MBBS in India. And once you get your MD degree, you can become a doctor there. But this one is a bit more costly. I'll talk about this. So like first talking about USMLE, the first USMLE has a whole process. So there's step one, which now like is going pass fail, like by January, after January 26, 2022, like it will become pass fail. So like everybody has to write step one, then just step two CK. This still will remain numerical. So I have a 271 on the step two CK, which is like in the 99th percentile. And you guys can watch my videos on step one and step two CK, like on my channel. I'll link them down below so you can check it out. After that, everybody has to write OET, which is like, so what happened was step two CS was the exam that was like used to assess our patient clinical skills and as well as communication skills. However, because of COVID, it got discontinued. And now like what has replaced USMLE step 2 CS is OET. And this is especially for international medical students, people who have done their medicine people who have done their medicine from US, like their degree from US, don't have to write OET because they will be proficient in that. And in the end, there's step three. So this is optional. What happens is a lot of the times, a lot of medical students like end up writing step three before matching into a residency in the US. Okay, so that's fine too, but it's not a requirement. You can write this like, you know, before going into your PGY3. So like you can write that. So PGY2, like for a lot of residency programs, PGY2 is the time when a lot of people write their USMLE step three, and everybody has to go through this in the end. So let's explore the first pathway to become a doctor in America. So that is going to your national medical school. So for me, that is like India is my I'm an Indian by nationality, right? So I have to write my pre-med exam, that is NEET UG, then go to a medical school, which is about 5.5 years here, get my degree, which is MBBS. And remember, MBBS here is an undergraduate degree, right? But like for doctors in America, like who want to become a doctor, like there, I'll get into this, there like med school is not a UG degree. It's actually a graduate degree. It's very interesting. I'll get into that later in the last pathway. And this requires about 4.5 years of, your studies and then 1 year of your internship, right? That's something you have to do. And after this, you can write your USMLE step one, step two, and get into med school, get into residency in America, right? Whatever you want. The second way to go about it is, let's say you have to go to an international med school. You didn't get that good in NEET rank, or you couldn't go to an Indian medical school, to your national medical school. So what you can do is you can like go to international medical schools such as in Russia, Armenia, and China, and you can like finish your degree there with whatever degree you get. And the thing is, even after that, you can do USMLE. And the best part about like going to international medical schools is there is no internship required, because there is something called as Pathway 6 by ECFMG, which is the Educational Council for Medical Graduation. And that pathway 6 is for people who do their medicine from outside of India. And through pathway 6, you don't really need internship, which is really a good thing. And secondly, there is no need to clear the foreign medical graduate exam, which a lot of people who do their MBBS outside of India take to get back into India to practice medicine. So you don't need to write FMGE. That's one of like the best parts. And again, this is not that expensive. It's very affordable, right? Even like going to your own national medical school can be affordable. The exception being going to a private school or a management seat, which can be again expensive. But like, I feel like going to your home country medical school and international medical school, such as Russia and Armenia, which are non-US based. So they are not that expensive. And like, it can be done. The last way that a lot of people don't know is like going into a US medical school. So like to go to a US medical school for international students, everybody first has to write SAT, which is like an exam. And after you write SAT, you have to do your pre-med. So, and this is your UG degree. Please remember, in India, MBBS is the UG degree. For them, like pre-med is their UG degree, medical school, which gives them the MD. And remember, this is the equivalent to MBBS in India. So their MD actually is equivalent to MBBS. So after you go to your medical school, which is about four. So the pre-med program is about 4 years. So everybody has to do it. There are scholarships for this, right? But the fees, like let's say you don't get a scholarship, the fees is about like $40,000 per year. And since this is a 4-year program, it will amount up to like $160,000. And it can be even more. But like, yeah, like there are scholarships. You can check about it if you want to. But after you do your pre-med, like which has to have biology and stuff, you go into medical school there, which will grant you the MD degree. Again, this is an MBBS equivalent. It is not PG. So, and this is about 4 years, right? And this is again graduate school for them. For us, it's an undergraduate school. So after doing like their medical school, everybody can apply for residency. And during their medical school, they'll give their USMLE step one. Most US medical students give their USMLE step one like by the second year. So in the second year, they end up giving their USMLE step one. Their step two CK, they give like about in the third or the fourth year. That's up to them. But like that's how they go about it. Even they write USMLE. And once they get in residency, they end up becoming a doctor, right? So these are the three pathways. Like, and the thing about the US medical school is the medical school here is actually pretty expensive. Again, it's about $40,000 to $60,000 for 1 year. And since it's 4 years, you're gonna pay about something like $160,000 to $240,000 to go here. So the total cost of this pathway ends up going somewhere between $320,000 to $500,000. So that's pretty expensive. The visa you require for US medical schools is about like is the F1 visa to get there. So that's what people do. It's the student visa. So guys, that's about it. Like and subscribe if you like this video, and please let me know if you want to watch anything else. Thank you.